On November 17, 2017, Today.com published an article about how Carl Pilemer, author of 30 Lessons of Living, Tried and True Advice from the Wisest Americans, and his team interviewed 1,500 people over 65 about what they regret most about their life. You guess what? Most of the top things people above age 65 regret are things they did not do, the business risks they did not take, the relationships they did not build, the trips they did not take, etc. That's why Mark Twain said, 20 years from now, you'll be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did do. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, discover. A few decades from today, when you look back at your life, you won't remember the risk you take, which led to some mistakes, because you should have seen how those mistakes make you smarter. 20 years from today, when you look back at your life, you won't remember those businesses you tried and failed at, because those failures must have shown you how to do it right next time. Many years from today, most of your regrets would be about things you didn't do, the business idea you never implemented, the relationship you never built, the journey you're afraid to take, and the partner you don't show how much you love. Even though so many young people are afraid of taking risks or daring the unknown because they feel that they could make a serious mistake that might affect their lives for a long time, the biggest mistake in life is not to make mistakes. 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did do. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, discover. Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela was born on 18 July 1918. As a little boy, Mandela didn't see anything wrong with the apartheid regime of his country. He believed that the whites were doing good to educate the poor black. However, as this curious man grew up, he started seeing how it wasn't fair that his people were judged and relegated to the background because of their color. When Mandela started voicing his anger about this evil, so many people in his day warned him not to try the impossible. For such people, it was impossible to kick against the cell wall of the ruling class. Mandela, however, wouldn't listen. He stood against racism in South Africa and lost everything for that single cause. He lost his marriage, never saw his kids growing, and was named a terrorist by many governments of the world. But he ended up being the most powerful person, the president, in the same country, where he was put into prison for almost 3 decades. Now let's assume for a moment that Mandela didn't dare to stand against injustice. What then would his life look like? Well, he would have relative peace. He would probably live a normal life, have a great marriage, and see his kids growing. But looking back to his life at age 70, he would know that he had lived for nothing. 20 years from now, you'll be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did do. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, discover. In the year 2010, I came across a quote from Theodore Roosevelt. This quote changed my life and kept me fighting in the business world till I succeeded, and I'd like you to pay close attention to it. It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who does strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms, the great devotions, spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows, in the end, the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory nor defeat. All my years of trials in the business world, I went back again and again to this very quote because it shows me that success isn't the end goal of life, but actions. This quote shows me that even if I fail after I have tried all my best, I would still be happy that I am at least not a coward. Listen to me, young people. Easy life, success, or peace isn't the end goal of life. The end goal of life is fulfillment, and that only comes to people who dare life, attempt great things, and pursue worthwhile goals. Even if at the end of the day you fail to achieve the great dream you pursue, you'll still be proud of yourself for being so courageous, and that's fulfillment. 20 years from now, you'll be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did do. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, discover. Mahatma Gandhi said, "It's the action, not the fruit of the action, that's important." The greatest pride you'll ever have about your life is that you attempt a great thing. Whether you succeed or fail, the mere fact that you are courageous enough to step out and go after your dream has separated you from the 97% of the world who merely wished, and that's a great accomplishment. So, stop procrastinating. Step out. Try things. Dare life. 20 years from now, you'll be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did do. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, discover. You will not regret this future.